Time to hunt down these vestiges. What up, what up, what up, guys? Celeviathan here, back with another reaction today. Today we are continuing up The Legend of Vox Machina. We're on season 2, episode 3, and so sorry for my tone-deaf voice there. So Vox Machina heads over to Vasselheim to try to recruit some help from Vasselheim's, I guess, army. But it seemed as though like the sanctuary here, which are the leaders of Vasselheim, were not really down with helping Vox Machina. So they definitely had to like find some more help in other places, where they went to this group of hunters called the Slayer's Take. Now the Slayer's Take has a patron there who is a Sphinx, and it seemed as though that the Sphinx there had a lot more to provide for Vox Machina than the leaders of Vasselheim could ever. The Sphinx here has provided Vox Machina with a goal to find the vestiges of Divergence. Now the vestiges of Divergence, they seem to be these weapons that used to be able to take on the gods, you know? So it's definitely going to be able to help out against these dragons, because they definitely have some godlike powers. So now they have their first goal, which is the Matron of Ravens, I believe, is the first vestige that they gotta go get. So it's definitely gonna be a great, great adventure. We're not gonna waste any time. Let's get started with this. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, guys. Turn on notifications down below so you know when I upload next, man. And drop down some comments on your thoughts on the reaction. I'd love to hear it, guys. But we're not gonna waste any time. Let's get started with The Legend of Vox Machina, Season 2, Episode 3, The Sunken Tomb. Let's go. Ah, great. We're starting right back here in this complete and utter destruction. These poor people. This is the literal hell.
Your offerings grow ever smaller. I trust the remaining treasure has been wrung from Iman.
As you commanded, Thordak. Every last ounce delivered to your feet.
And Westron is on the brink of ruin, my king.
Well, it looks like they've been going to work, man. Westron is completely in ruin, and now, like, it looks like their plan is in motion.
Run!
Where the heck is Pike here, by the way? That's what I was kind of wondering a little bit. Like, when did she get here? Yeah, I knew it. It definitely Pike wasn't gonna be there. It was definitely some type of like dreamwalking kind of thing.
He just wiped them out. I couldn't save them.
I found the lake Osisa told us about over the next ravine.
Fantastic. Let's go.
Wait, the bad news?
No tomb.
Did the Sphinx lie to us?
It must be across the lake.
I feel like the tomb is gonna be underwater or something.
I'll slide over and check it out.
Guys, this is the best!
Oh god, it's the Atlanteans from Aquaman.
Fucking
that was definitely the guy from the Slayer's Take.
That would be us.
Hey, hello. I'm glad they kind of joined in to come help.
What are you?
Osisa thought you might need our help.
Well, at least Antlers here is happy to see me. Right.
Oh, well, yeah, I mean.
What the shit just grabbed me?
Adaro, fish people. The tomb was built for the Matron of Ravens, the goddess of death. It enshrines the body of her ancient champion. His name was Pervon.
Pervon?
Last name, Pedo Bear, maybe?
Where'd you pick up that beauty?
Oh, this old thing. Well, I had to kill a demon for it. Don't be jealous.
Well, that's an interesting and yet chunky belt. What's it do?
Why we got Grog looking like Kratos right now?
That's all.
It got him to grow a beard.
Beard.
Bro, beard belt.
You must be fairly annoyed that Osisa told us about it before you.
Hadn't crossed my mind.
They followed us. We obviously can't trust them.
Sister, do not go far from me.
I think Vax here has a little bit of a struggle because of that thing that he keeps seeing. But oh yes, we're finally going to get into a little bit of a backstory.
Just hurry. Father could be back any moment. It's beautiful.
What are you doing?
I only want
that heirloom has been passed down through generations of elven nobility.
Is this the father that she's been trying to get her approval from for her whole life, man?
That's enough.
Jeez. Like that. Damn, what an asshole type of father.
Get your things. Don't bother having us followed.
Damn, yo, this was the father that she wanted so badly to get her approval from. This bastard.
Now see if you can follow me. Lake. Tomb.
Then your map's wrong. Look, the tomb here is upside down.
Voila.
Actually, we were thinking Earth, Wind, and Fire here could assist.
See, I was right, man. It's under the water. Wow, it really was an underwater tomb. That just reminds me of like some type of RPG or something. this is gonna be interesting, yo, going through this this labyrinth. Or a dungeon. That's a better word. Dungeon.
Ugh, smells like fish and death.
Why would Ossis tell them about the tomb when we're the ones doing our work? Those vestiges belong with the Take, not some tourists.
Shouldn't be too hard to swipe it out from under them.
Man, these two are going to be sorely mistaken if they're trying to rob Vox Machina.
Just keep close.
Oh, don't want to trip on this.
I swear to God, Grog. I swear to God.
Hi. Lucky I was here.
Yeah, I am. Was. Lucky. I mean.
Vax, you better not be allowing this shit, man.
That might have been my fault.
No.
Vax, stay where you are.
I'm coming.
Well, no use waiting around here.
Maybe we should just go back. If you gave Father a chance, you'd see...
I'd see what I've seen 1,000 times before. There's nothing we'll do will ever be good enough for him because of what we are.
What are they? Because he just said because of what we are. What kind of mistakes are they? That's a little bit interesting there, what he just said.
I don't need rescuing, and I don't need you. Hold up.
Damn, I make this look good.
He really does, yo, he really does.
Well, that's not ancient.
It seems something moved into this tomb after it sank.
Oh yeah, I knew it was gonna be the fish people, or whatever, Ardaro, whatever they called them. That is the complete opposite of fun-loving Grog right there. They need to take that sword away from him.
Age. Last one's always the toughest. But don't worry, I'll save you.
She got it right, though. She got it right.
Vex, Natalia!
Oh, shit! Jump on!
Yeah, he fell off.
All yours, Trinket.
You're right. There's nothing worse than bad fish.
Grog, you okay, buddy?
Oh, I think I just heard a roof fall on me.
When you were fighting those things, you seemed...
Wait, where are Cash and Zara?
We didn't have to do that.
I beg to differ. The vestige is supposedly in Pervon's sarcophagus.
You impressed? 'Cause you fucking should be.
Yes, yes, you're very clever.
Why did that one fish just light up over there? That kind of made an indication that they went into the wrong place.
Grog, for fuck's sake!
What's that?
No. Don't step on anything, don't pull anything, don't... do anything.
Why do they have such a huge compulsion to the spring traps? They're like, ooh, what's over there? Ooh, what's that? Ooh, touch. God, Indiana Jones would be so ashamed of all of them.
Hey, don't keep all the loot for yourself.
No promises. The second Sphinx. What have we here?
Maybe we shouldn't.
Your brother certainly wouldn't approve.
Then perhaps just a peek.
So that Sphinx thing didn't have anything to do with the Matron of Ravens. It's something completely different. The second Sphinx. Interesting.
The Deathwalker's ward.
Part of me was feeling like that was gonna be a bad idea that they did that. Shit, is she dead? Close to it? What?
I was gone for 30
what the fuck
seconds,
just happened? What happened?
Max!
What's wrong? What happened?
You left me.
But this is why he kept saying, stay close, stay close, stay close.
Do not go far from me.
I won't. I swear it.
Damn, man. Shit. Is she actually dead here? Like, dead dead? What? That was the end of the episode? Oh my god. Oh my god! Wow! I mean, I know she's probably not dead-dead confirmed, but like, man, that was still a shocking moment and unexpected as heck. So it was really cool seeing us actually go into a dungeon and kind of go through like the corridors, not try to spring traps, fighting mobs and stuff of monsters, even fighting like a little bit of a mini boss there too before you can get to your prize. It was great to see that the Slayers take Zara and the other guy, I don't really remember his name, kind of joined in on the fun here. Them kind of coming in was a little bit helpful. They showed us where the Matron of Raven's tomb was. Now they got hasty and ditched them. Vox Machina trying to take the prize for themselves, and they definitely went to the wrong direction. It was great to see that we finally dived into a little bit of Vax and Vex's history here. You know, it seemed like their dad was a bit of an asshole. And even when Vax said something like, he'll never accept us for what we are. So what exactly are they, right? What is it that their father cannot accept, right? Is it like their mother's heritage? Is it like them being born as twins? Maybe that's an omen. I don't know, but there's a lot of mystery there as well. But her dying at the end there, oh, I did not expect that. I knew something, I felt like something bad was about to happen when they separated. I'm feeling that when she got shot, there was a little bit of like feathers of raven feathers around, right? So I'm thinking she's not actually dead, but she's going through a trial of some sort. So we're gonna definitely see that next episode. But for this reaction, I will see you guys around. Take care and have yourselves a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.